Hello friends, welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently friends, we have 6 series that target your prelims and 1 series that is mains oriented. So what we do in these prelims series, we cover your questions, MCQ based questions, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So currently we are covering the 6 topics, that is history, ancient India, medieval India, modern India, geography and environment and polity. And each topic is, one day has been allotted to each topic. So we will continue to cover the MCQs of each topic or each of these 6 topics till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019 and we will end this series only 1 day before your prelims exam. So as of now we are covering only 10 questions daily, but slowly we will increase the number of questions to 20. So let's start a discussion of today's lecture, that is geography lecture MCQ series. So today is lecture number 6 of geography. So what is the first question here? It is on your screen. You are an intelligence officer and have been taken to an unknown location in Australia. The intelligence team back in India knows your longitude due to time zone in which you have been captivated. You need to communicate only your latitude to the officers in India to help them evacuate you. You can know the latitude of your place by. So friends, here the question is basically simple thing is said to you that you have to tell your latitude. How can you tell your latitude when you are in Australia? So there is not to be much confused about this question. So don't think much. You are in Australia at some location and you have to tell the latitude of your place to the intelligence officers and the back home in India. So friends, the option A is measuring the angle of the pole star from your place, B finding out the rate of rotation of the moon, C measuring the rate of revolution of earth around the sun, and D is it is not possible by any of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the first statement is wrong, because most of the students could have said that the A is correct answer. Because friends, you are in Australia and Australia is in southern hemisphere from where the pole star is not visible. You can measure your place of latitude if you are in North Pole by measuring the angle your position makes with the pole star, and then you can subtract it from 90 degree, and this will give you your latitude place. But from the southern hemisphere the pole star is not visible, so obviously A statement is not correct. And further, B and C are not correct because moon's rotation has no effect on your position, and it cannot tell your position because moon rotates at the same time, it revolves around the earth in the same time as the earth rotates around itself. So B is also incorrect, C is also incorrect. So the solution is D, that is it is not possible by any of the above. So let's move on to the next question. The solution here is D. So justification is given before you that the pole star is helpful only in case of northern hemisphere and not in case of southern hemisphere. So basically this is the way in you can calculate your latitudinal place. You have to measure the angle that your place is making with the pole star in case you are in northern hemisphere, because pole star is exactly at the north pole, so it indicates north direction. And once you get your place angle with respect to pole star, and then you can subtract it from 90 degree and you will get your location. So this is about the first question. Let's move on to the second question. The second question is Strait of Hormuz lies sandwiched between. So friends, there is a Strait of Hormuz. If it is in Asia itself, so you have to tell it is in between which of the following nations? A United Arab Emirates and Oman, B Oman and Iran, C Qatar and Iran, D Saudi Arabia and Qatar. So let me tell you friends that the correct option is B, that is Oman and Iran. So the solution is B. I have shown you it is shown in before your screen. Here is Strait of Hormuz, so you can see it more closely. Let me show you. 1 second, here is Strait of Hormuz. So you can see here is Oman. So here you can see the Oman. Let me show you. So this is Oman, and this is Iran, and here is Strait of hormones. So you are here. So it is sandwiched between Oman and Iran. So this is this is the question. So it is easy. It is quite easy, and you have to basically prepare the map portion so that you can remember these things. So let's move on to your learning part. That basically learning part is that it is. Zoom out of it. Learning part is that that it provides the only sea passes from the Persian Gulf to the open ocean, and is one of the world's most strategically important choke points, because 20% of the world petroleum passes through it, and it is a strategic location. So it because 20% of the world petroleum passes through this Strait of Hormuz. So let's move on to your third question. Your third question is, arrange the following locations in the West Asia from west to east. So friends, I have taken up the map based questions today. So here you have to arrange these locations from west to east, that is Azerbaijan, Ashgabat, Tel Aviv and Damascus. So if you have seen the map of West Asia carefully, then you will be able to answer this question, because Tel Aviv is in Israel, and it is westernmost, and after that comes the Damascus, and then after that comes our third four, and then comes out Tel Aviv as Damascus, and then comes your Azerbaijan, and then comes your Ashgabat. So the correct option is, sorry friends, so there is mistake. So I got confused, sorry. But that solution is D, friends, because let me check also in the map. Let me show you the map. So here is the map. Azerbaijan is western to the Ashgabat. So here is the Azerbaijan. You can see here the Azerbaijan, and here is the Ashgabat. It is in Turkmenistan, and here is Tel Aviv, which is in Israel, and here is Damascus. So you can see that you can arrange in this manner. So here I also got confused, so sorry for the confusion. So let's move on to your next question. Let me come out of the Zoom area, and let's move on to your justification. So justification is, Tel Aviv is in Israel, whereas Damascus is in Syria. So it lies to the east of Tel Aviv. So 4 must come after 3. So fourth question is, so 4 must come after 3. So the answer is 3 4 1 2, so not 2 1. So answer is D. So let's move on to your next question, the fourth question. 1.5 degree channel lies closest to which of the following countries? So here we have been asked that this 1.5 degree channel lies closest to which of the following. So let me tell you friends, 1.5 degree channel is basically name given to a water channel by its latitudinal place. So obviously you are knowing that 1.5 degree channel is basically its latitudinal place. So so you have to judge which of the country is closest to it. A, Sri Lanka. B, India. C, Maldives. D, Myanmar. So let me tell you friends that India cannot be the answer, because India is above Sri Lanka. So Sri Lanka and Sri Lanka can also be not the answer, and Myanmar can also not be the answer, because Myanmar is quite to the north side of equator. So this cannot be the answer. So 1.5 degrees basically close to 0 degree, that is equator. So the proper answer is, the solution is Maldives, which is close. Actually the 1.5 degree channel it is in Maldives itself. So the C is the correct answer. So here I have to show you a map. If I have included, sorry friends, I forgot to include the map. So you can guess the location by the channel by its latitude itself. Logically you should be closest to Maldives, because Indian territory starts nearly 8 degrees north, and Sri Lanka follows close by. So A and B can be eliminated, and Myanmar lies above Sri Lanka, so obviously D cannot be the answer. So let's move on to the fifth question. Fifth question is, which of the following is the most appropriate analogy with regards to relationship between a protected area and biosphere? So the options are A, a tree in a forest, B, core and mantle of the earth, C, ionosphere and mesosphere, D, any two celestial bodies. So friends, let me tell you that the protected area is a kind of zone that has been declared by a particular national government or state government for the protection of flora and fauna, and biosphere is basically that zone of earth where life exists. So friends, carefully note the word here, biosphere, because we are not talking about biosphere reserve. We are saying here biosphere. So biosphere is that zone where life exists, and or the life can only here can you can see that the life can only exist in case of a tree in a forest. So tree, obviously, it is in biosphere, and it and a forest can also be a protected area. There can be a particular zone that can be declared as a protected area. So the correct answer is A, that is a tree in a forest. So the answer is solution is A. So here is the justification. So basically, biosphere is that part of the earth in which living organisms exist. And please note that we are not talking about biosphere reserve. Keep note of it. And friends, protected areas are just like any large ecosystem which have been declared established as to protect our flora and fauna and their habitats. So this is about your question, and let's come to your sixth question. Muntjac, cheetal and blue bull are most likely to be found in. So friends, let me tell you that I will tell you the answer, but before that you have to comment in the comment box, and you have to tell me that what are these basically, to which genus they belong. Are they cow, or as the name suggests, blue bull, or they are from they are antelope or other thing. So you have to tell me in the comment box. So you are, if you participate in the quiz, it is also motivating for us, that so that we come to know that students are following us. So we have been asked that where are these found. A, Nilgiri Mountains of Southern India. B, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. C, Protected Areas of Central India. D, Srinagar and Ladakh. So friends, it is a quite difficult question, because you must be knowing the range of different animals. So these three are simultaneously found in the Central India. So Protected Areas of Central India, like Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve, there these muntjacs, that muntjac is also known as barking deer. So cheetal and blue bull are found. So they are basically antelope. I told you, as I have told you to comment in the comment box. So I have already told you, I forgot that. So answer is C. So solution is C. So here you can see that the learning is that sal, teak, mango, jamun, silver ferns, arjun extra are found, and are the flora and chinkara, blue bull, that is, and darking bear, that is muntjac, and cheetah, leopard, wild dog, wolf extra are examples of fauna of the Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve. So here you can see the explanation. The blue bull is also found in dry lowlands in the foothills of Himalayas, and similar is the case with cheetal, which is also found in the western India, that is Rajasthan, Gujarat, and then Babbar Tarai belt in the northern part, which is the foothill, which forms the foothill of Himalayas, and then UP and Uttaranchal to Nepal and West Bengal and Sikkim to Assam, and then forest valleys of Bhutan. So it is quite spread in the foothill zone of Himalayas, that Babbar Tarai belt of the foothill Himalayas. So let's move on to your next question, seventh question. The fluvial riverine island is formed by the Brahmaputra river system and mostly inhabited by Mishing tribal people. It is now center of Assamese Neo-Vaishnavite culture. The island is. So friends, here we have been asked that there is fluvial riverine island, and which is formed by Brahmaputra river, and it is mostly inhabited by Mishing tribal people, and there is the dominant culture is Neo-Vaishnavite culture. So we have to tell the island, to which island this question refers to. The A option is Narkondam Island, B is River Island of Majoli, C Matoa Island, D Forest Islands of Thembang. So let me tell you friends that the correct option is B, that is River Island of Majoli, that is the largest river island in the world, river island made by any river. So the solution is B, it is made by Brahmaputra, and it is the largest river island, and it is also the first island district. So in June 2016, Assam government had declared it as the district, and this made it the first island district, India's first island district. So also it has been nominated for World Heritage Site, and it has been in the tentative list of UNESCO. So learning is basically, it is surrounded by Subansiri north and main Brahmaputra river on the south. So island has some 65 satras, that is monasteries adhering to Vaishnavism. But due to frequent flooding, they have been relocated now. So these now monasteries have been relocated. And this Majoli island is inhabited mainly by the Mishing tribal people, but though other tribes also exist there, that is Deori and Sonowal Khachri tribes. So they also exist there. So let us move on to the let me tell you, it is now center of new Vaishnavite culture. So and there it is home to many rare and endangered avifauna species, including migratory birds. So this is about your seventh question. Let's move on to the eighth question. The eighth question is, the bright streak of a meteor lasts for a very short time because. So friends, you might have seen the meteors that enter Earth's atmosphere. So when they enter, they are approaching the Earth very the surface of the Earth in a very very high speed. So due to friction, what happens, they burn, and they are the water in them gets evaporated. So the bright streak does not last very long, so it lasts for a very short time. So the correct answer is D, that is friction due to the atmosphere evaporates the meteor quickly. So the answer is, solution is D. So here is the explanation, that it is basically a small object that enters Earth's atmosphere, and at Earth's atmosphere, and due to the friction, it gets it kind of it it goes away and glows and evaporates quickly due to the friction. So it lasts for a very short time. So let's move on to your ninth question. Ninth question is, these places are on the river course of Ganga. Which of these has the northernmost latitude? A. Kanpur, B. Allahabad, C. Varanasi, D. Murshidabad. So friends, if you have seen the Ganga course, then there are different places that fall in its course. And these are the places, and we have to tell that which of the following of these places is on the northernmost latitude. So let me tell you friends that the correct answer is Kanpur, because Kanpur is at the northernmost, and after that comes Allahabad, and then comes Varanasi. So friends, about Murshidabad, let me tell you, Murshidabad is in West Bengal, so it cannot be the answer. So it is in West Bengal, and it is not in the course in the course of River Ganga. So the answer is Kanpur. So here is picture shown here before you. So you can see here that this is the Dev Prayag, and here is Rishikesh, Haridwar, and Kanpur, Allahabad, Varanasi. So let me tell you that Varanasi is above Allahabad and not below. Sorry for the mistake. So it is above, quite above the Allahabad, and then Patna, and then it is in West Bengal. So obviously Murshidabad is in West Bengal, so it is below Kanpur. So this is about here, this question. So let's see. Now let's come to the last question of today's lecture. That is 10th question. 10th question is, arrange the following gulfs of South Asia from north to south. So we have to arrange the gulfs from south of South Asia from north to south. First is Gulf of Martaban. Second is Gulf of Khambat. Third is Gulf of Mannar. Fourth is Gulf of Kutch. So friends, you would be knowing about India at least. I expect that from you people. If you don't know, then please see the map regularly, so that you can have a good idea about different locations, so that if the question comes, you do not get confused in the exam hall. So let me tell you that the Gulf of Kutch is in the northernmost part. It comes to the north, and after that comes the Gulf of Khambat. It is also in Gujarat, and here you can let me tell you that Gulf of Martaban is in Myanmar, and the Gulf of Mannar is in Tamil Nadu. So this answer is, we have to choose the correct answer. That is, first is Gulf of Kutch. So obviously fourth will be front. So obviously you can see, if you have the idea of Gulf of Kutch, where is Gulf of Kutch, so you will be able to attempt the question. So because Gulf of Kutch is and the it comes in the northernmost latitude. So answer is B. So here it is, solution is B. So here I can show you in the map. So here is Gulf of Khambat. You can see here Gulf of Khambat, and here is Gulf of Kutch, and then comes your Gulf of Martaban. This is in Myanmar, and then comes your Tamil Nadu, where here it is Gulf, here it is Gulf of Mannar. So these are the locations, so keep them in mind. These questions are asked repeatedly by UPSC, so these are important to revise. So friends, this is all about today's video. So this is all about explanation. If you like this video, please like it, share it with your friends, and if you have any suggestion, then tell me in the comment box. I will certainly consider your suggestion. And lastly friends, we have a Telegram channel also, the link of which I will provide in the description box, so you can check the link and can join our Telegram channel and can associate with us. And friends, if you liked our video, then please subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications relating to updates that we do on our channel relating to CSE 2019. So thank you friends, thank you very much, have a nice day.